First of all, I want to apologize to you guys. I know it's been a couple of weeks since I've made a video. I've been hard drive mining. It's not really mining, it's more like farming. You might be wondering what that actually means. Well, I was originally going to make a video about migrating my Plex server into this new tower, but then I got sucked down the rabbit hole that is Chia crypto farming. After many hours of reading about this new cryptocurrency called Chia, a few weeks ago, I started getting very excited about how much potential it has, and I think it will become a major cryptocurrency. I'll explain why, what hard drive mining or farming is, and how you can easily get started right now with the old parts you have lying around like I did in this video. Also, everything I purchased for my Chia farming and plotting can be found in the links in the video description below. If you're anything like me, you cringe when you run out of physical space for hard drives in your server and you're forced to replace a small 1, 3, or 4 terabyte drive with a larger capacity 10, 12, or 14 terabyte drive. I mean, it just feels wasteful, right? Throwing away a 4 terabyte drive in a box to collect dust never feels good. And over the past few years, I've filled up my share of boxes with small hard drives. To my surprise, that is exactly what Chia is great at being farmed on, a bunch of old hard drives. This past week, I blew the dust off all my old hard drives and converted them into a giant Chia farm. So let's quickly start off with the basics. What is Chia? Chia is a new green cryptocurrency. It'll be tradable starting tomorrow, May 3rd, 2021. It was created by Bram Cohen, whose name might sound familiar as he was also the inventor of BitTorrent. Why is that important? Well, first of all, Bram is a genius. And second of all, Chia is the first and only cryptocurrency since Bitcoin to use the Nakamoto consensus algorithm. Chia relies on proof of space and time instead of proof of work like Bitcoin. This ultimately means it doesn't leverage a GPU, and more importantly, it won't lead to more GPU shortages. That said, due to some of the recent news about hard drive shortages in China, this is looking like it's already becoming a huge sensation. It's possible this could cause hard drive and flash storage shortages in the US soon if it hasn't already, so I encourage you to get started now like I did if you're at all interested in pursuing Chia farming. The biggest hurdle to overcome is also why I think flash or NVMe storage will become difficult to find in the coming months. Even though it does not yet have a price, you can find a calculator here that defaults to $20 a Chia to determine how much money your spare parts might earn you. I think, judging by its recent exponential growth, that long term, it's going to be worth a hell of a lot more than $20. There are two parts to mining Chia: farming and plotting. Farming is like Bitcoin mining, but it uses very little resources. Before you can start, you have to make plots by plotting. A lot like you might till a plot for a farm, you must put in some work before you can actually start farming and collecting Chia. A plot is used to farm. Plotting is a slow process. It's sped up by utilizing NVMe or SATA SSD flash storage for your temporary space. You'll need about 239 gigabytes of temporary space per plot while plotting, and about 101 gigabytes of space wherever you put your plot when it's finished. Once you have plotted out all of the available space on your hard drives, you farm. As I mentioned earlier, farming requires very little resources. It's almost like idling your computer, but you don't want your disks to spin down. This is the appeal of Chia to me. It uses very little electricity if you set it up right, once you get to the farming stage, and I think it'll have huge upsides from a value proposition. So what did I build? Well, as I said, I started off with the goal of building a new Plex server that used less power and could take advantage of my external 3D printable enclosure that holds 24 3.5 inch hard drives. If you haven't checked out that video yet, go give it a watch, as it really came in handy for farming and plotting Chia. This is the rough build of what I put together. What's great about this build is its cost. It's cheap. It also has a decent number of PCI Express 16X slots for HBAs to connect hard drives, NVMe for storage, or for 10 gig networking. I have a video where I'll break down how I'm doing 10 gig for cheap at home, how to optimize it, and how to actually get 10 gigabit speeds, and how I'm leveraging 10 gig for Chia plotting. The motherboard I chose was an X99 ASUS Deluxe 2 motherboard, but you can find great deals on single and dual socket X99 motherboards on Amazon. They go for between $115 and $175, and links to them can be found in the video description below. If I were to do this with the intent on Chia, I would purchase a dual socket X99 motherboard to have more CPU horsepower for plotting. I chose this motherboard because the E5-2600 V3 processors are really cheap right now on eBay, specifically the 12-core E5-2680 V3 processors, which can be found on Amazon right now for only $152. They have great performance for both Plex and for Chia plotting. Plotting faster will ultimately get you started farming quicker and collecting Chia faster. You can go with the same motherboard I did, or go with one of these alternatives. Either way, they have lots of PCI Express lanes, which is important as you'll want to add things like NVMe storage, 10 gig NICs, or HBAs to actually connect your hard drives to your server. The processor I chose was the 2699 V3. As I had originally purchased this for Plex, that said, the 2680 V3 is again only $152 on Amazon right now, and the link's in the video description. If you get a dual socket motherboard, you'll have a total of 24 cores and 48 threads if you choose the 2680 V3. That should provide some pretty awesome plotting performance. I'd also recommend some MP600 2TB NVMe drives, as you'll want to leverage those for the plotting, specifically for the temporary space. You can pick these up on Amazon for pretty cheap as well, but you'll really want a high endurance NVMe drive. I've included a link to describe what that means, and I don't want to go into too much detail here, but ultimately it just means you can write to it a lot before it dies. To cool the processor, I ended up buying this cheap ID cooling ZoomFlow AIO. It might not look like much, but even under load, it keeps my 2699 V3 CPU down to a cool 53°C, as measured with an ambient temperature of 73 degrees. The case I went with was the NZXT H510. I didn't need a case with a lot of capacity for 3.5-inch hard drives, because I'm using my 24-bay 3D printable enclosure for that. I purchased a cheap $20 LSI HBA, which I made a previous video about. Each of these HBAs give you the ability to plug in an additional 16 hard drives, and if you couple it with this HP SAS expander, you can add an additional 28 drives for only $90. You'll need a $20 LSI 9216E, two of these cables, and the $70 HP SAS expander. The cables from the HBA plug in here and here, and then you'll have all seven of these ports for the breakout cables. This is what I did, as I found it to be the cheapest way to add lots of storage capacity to a server. You should subscribe to our channel, because I'm going to be making a follow-up video going into detail about how all of this works and some of the other options available. So this is what I've built. Up until this point, I had printed three enclosures while making the previous 3D printable enclosure videos. Now they are all being used to plot and farm Chia. As plotting takes some time, and since the coin won't be tradable until tomorrow, I've been putting all of my energy into plotting on old hard drives that I had lying around from upgrades to my Plex server over the years. I even went as far as to buy a few 14TB drives from Best Buy. As of the making of this video, no one actually knows what Chia or XCH will be worth, but I believe it will be extremely valuable long term. I think the viability of something like Chia makes so much more sense than other cryptocurrencies that are incredibly wasteful. Links to everything to build this yourself can be found in the video description below. Please go check out Coin Breakthrough's channel. He has some great videos on Chia, and come back here as I'll be releasing some very interesting content on 10 gig networking for Chia, the plotting performance of different processors, including a 3990X, as well as connecting and making sense of all of this stuff. I also will continue making Plex videos. I've run Plex and MB benchmarks for the 3990X as well as the RTX 3090. The results will definitely surprise you. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like and subscribe.